today is going to be a very good Friday because I actually have my biggest motivator and biggest supporter with me, who is that guy right over there. That is the husband, and I am going to link his Instagram down below just in case you want to check out his own transformation, which was one of my biggest inspirations to get into this whole fitness thing. I swear it will blow your mind. But yeah, he's taking over babysitting duties, and I can get my workout earlier than usual. So yeah, today we're doing shoulders, and let's do it. So I'm starting this workout with some reverse flies using the Hectech machine. This is something that I've become really fond of, and I usually superset this with bent over reverse flies, but at this time I couldn't find any dumbbells that were light enough for that. So I also like to use a lot of mind-muscle connection here to keep my rear delts tense and prevent my traps from engaging too much, because they kind of tend to develop quicker. So that's also one of the reasons why you don't see me squeeze all the way to the back. Warning, you're gonna see me do a lot of weird facial expressions here because I'm really pushing myself for this move. These are lateral raises that my coach had me do, and I start off with the heaviest weight that I can manage and then drop set thrice, with the last set being until failure, to really burn out those medial delts. One thing that you have to remember with this move is to lift the weight with your elbows leading rather than your hands. What helps me is to visualize that I'm pushing something out rather than just having to lift the weight up with my hands. Lastly, I do these upright rows as a burnout, and I used to perform these with barbells or with a Smith machine, but I found that that engaged my traps too much. However, you can do these with dumbbells or kettlebells or even with cables to keep constant tension.
Alright you guys, so I just got done with my lifts for the day and my cardio. Right now I'm having 3 30-minute sessions of steady state and 2 HIIT sessions per week, and that's about it. So I'm currently having my post-workout meal, which is just the usual chicken breast, while Flynn is having, ta-da! Because he's loving and considerate like that.
before anything else, I actually wanted to give you a short update because I know in my previous video I mentioned that I was gonna upload a full day of eating with my ketogenic meals, but that's not gonna happen now because yesterday I actually had some sort of check in with my coach, and you know, we were making updates and all of that, and after going through this week's progress, he advised that we can actually get off keto and we're going to start to bring back carbs by next week. And the reason for that is, one, we were actually already able to achieve the physique that we were aiming for in terms of fat loss. It's not yet stage ready, it's like far from stage ready, but it's a better starting point for the next 18 to 19 weeks of prep left. He thinks that staying in keto wouldn't really be sustainable for me right now because, side story, and this is something that I was very open to him about, right now we're experiencing some feeding problems with my 4-year-old. And I mean, if you think that you have a picky eater, you have not met my kid. I mean, this kid takes picky eating to like a whole new level. And so because of that, we have been working with his occupational therapist, who also works with him with regard to his fine motor skills, and collaborating with his preschool and his developmentalpedia and all of those very lovely people. One of the tactics that we wanted to try was to model meal times with him, and that includes eating the regular meal. And we're Filipino, so a regular meal means there's rice in there. So given that I'm not really eating rice right now, it's kind of hard to demonstrate it to him. Because I mean, let's admit, kids are smart, and you can't just pretend to put it in your mouth and chew and go, you know, this is delicious, you know, you should try this. I mean, they pick up on it and they're gonna be like, don't bullshit me, Mom, I know you're not eating it. And so yeah, it's been pretty tricky since Flynn has also jumped on a keto thing with me. So both of us are not eating carbs at all. So it's kind of been a challenge to get our kids to eat. And yeah, so I brought that up with my coach, and he said that, you know, with my current lifestyle and my current priorities, staying on keto might not be the best option that we have. And that's one of the things that I think I touched up very lightly in my previous video. You know, the diet that you will have the most success with is one that fits your lifestyle. And I mean, it could be effective for you, but it's not going to be sustainable necessarily if, you know, there are some other factors that come into play. So that is why I will not be able to make a full day of eating video. And yeah, I'm excited to have carbs. Like I said, I missed my oats, which is weird because you'd think that the first thing I'd go for would be pizza or donut, but I actually miss my oatmeal. And I'm just currently waiting for updates from my coach regarding the new macros that will be coming in this weekend. How about you? How do you feel about
carbs
back in your life? He's excited. He's very excited. That's his excited face. Yeah, so that's it for the short video. I hope you enjoyed. Please give it a thumbs up if you did. Like, share, and subscribe if you want to see more. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye.